Will they spot one member popping on in from Loops with the
shotgun,
making the spray?
Hello there, PMPL fans. My name's Kaelaris, your host to our PMPL Americas, and I'm here to bring you exactly everything that actually went down in week two of the PMPL Americas. There was a lot of great action, a lot of great things to witness. Some of our players were able to pop off, some of our teams were able to pop off and really climb at the leaderboards here for the PMPL. First things first, let's take a look for week two. Who was the MVP of the week? And I know a lot of names may come to mind. However, when it comes to our actual MVP, it will be Carillo from Loops actually standing above the crowd. And when you look at the amount of damage that this guy has done, he really does stand head and shoulders above a lot of the players on the battleground. Some people might be thinking Acer, some people might be thinking some other names, but Carillo doing so much for Loops Esports, and you can really see that also reflected in the standings at the end of the week that we're going to be taking a look at a little bit later on, of course. So great stuff. Congratulations to Carillo once again. I know that even in week one as well, he was blasting out. So phenomenal performance by Carillo. For now, though, we can actually take a look and break down how everything was going from day to day as well. So let's take a look at day number one, as we can see the points that were able to come in here. And this was a big turning point for Loops Esports in particular, because before this, in week number one, they had a lot of points, but they had zero chicken dinners. Myself and the analysis guys were like, well, when are they going to get those chicken dinners? And not only did they get one chicken dinner on day number one, they got two chicken dinners, and that afforded them the number one place for the day here for day number six of the PMPL Americas. Aside from that, though, we saw Team Queso getting themselves the second place spot, and even though they didn't get any chicken dinners, they were super consistent. Two second places, a third place, a fourth place, and then a 12th place, but we'll not mind that, and a lot of kills to boot with that too. So Team Queso, one of seven's picks, doing very, very well to start off week number two. Let's move down a little bit as well and look at our 11th through 16th, just to re-jog your memory as to how things actually played out here. And Trem Careta Furacao did not have the easiest start by any means to the week. However, we did see them pick that up throughout the week to be able to push themselves up the ranking. So that's how it sits for day number six. We can move on now and see how things are going. Another thing that actually to mention there, in 15th place, you actually saw Grunto Esports. That was another team that eventually got those gears going. But anyway, let's take a look at day number seven now as well and get you up to speed with how things actually played out there for the PMPL Americas. All right, so this was a big day in PMPL Americas. Why, you ask? Well, because Tempo Storm set the record for a day's totals worth of points coming in with 122 points. Phenomenal stuff by them, absolutely fantastic. They got themselves two set first places, a second place, a third place, and a fifth place. Unprecedented consistency coming out from them. And in every single one of those games, they got themselves huge kills. 11 kills, 11 kills, 6 kills, 9 kills, 14 kills. It will be hard for any team to surpass that 122 mark that they were able to get. And remember in the previous day when I said that Trem Careta Furacao had a bit of a rough day? Well, they came back with a great day number two for that week, day number seven, of course, with a first place, second place, third place, and then the other two games, a few kills here and there. So very, very nice to see them get those 70 points. Let's take a look at our 11th through 16th as well. As unfortunately for Loops, despite having a first place overall production in the previous day, day number seven was not as kind to them by any means. They got themselves a fourth place in the last game with 7 kills. So, you know, the motor was running towards the end, but that's how things broke down. Another few other names in there, like Tribe Gaming. A lot of people are expecting some good consistency out of it. It wasn't the best day number seven for them, but I'm sure they end up bouncing back. Now let's move on to day number eight as well. There's a lot of days to cover. Follow me. As we take a look now and see how that actually all broke down. We had B4 for getting themselves the top spot here. By no means, you know, the most explosive day, an 80 points total coming out from them. However, very respectable indeed, getting themselves 2 second places with 7 and 8 kills, and a third place with 9 kills as well. And that was actually on the Sanhok match, and we like to see them fragging out there. Lazarus in second place, a great day for them, all things considered, with a first place 14 kills on that Sanhok game. And if you recall back to it, when the Northwest Circle came in, one circle I've been looking forward to, Lazarus had a perfect compound to be able to produce precise precision engineering from that. That was a mouthful, but that's how that's going to go. Now let's take a look at our 11th through 16th as well, as XQ getting themselves only the 11th place here in this day. And it's a little bit unexpected that, again, you kind of see some of these names down here. XQ, Tribe, not having the easiest of days by any means. But again, I can confirm the bounce back is real. So that's how number 8 sorted out. Now let's take a look at day number 9. And see how that shapes up as well. A lot of results coming in, but again, all of these teams really fighting tooth and nail to push themselves up the rankings. It was another great day for Loops Esports. They got themselves a first place here with 94 points, 2 chicken dinners. So across their 2 days where they actually got themselves the first place here on that particular day, they accrued 4 chicken dinners. Just great, great stuff coming out from Loops Esports, a team that a lot of people have their eyes on to win it all, win it big. And then, of course, XQ bouncing back from their previous day after not having the easiest of times, get themselves a second place, a first place with 16 kills on Erangel, then afforded them a great steamroll motion. And again, it was consistent throughout the day. First place, second place, fifth place, fifth place, seventh place. Brilliant stuff to see from XQ. And actually, one of my teams that I am assuming will be comfortably in towards that top 8 to go to World League. We'll see how they shape up later. Let's take a look at our 11th through 16th as well here for day number 9, as Crema Real Betis got themselves a spot of 11th there. We've seen a few middling performances from Crema Real Betis, but they are a team that's really kind of pushing the envelope when it comes to outwards rotations, coming in and playing, you know, a kind of passive game, looking for the more survivable thing of aspect of PUBG Mobile. And then with that, they're still able to take the fights as well. They're just playing it patient, saving a lot of their utility to the later stages, and then being able to get themselves chicken dinners later, potentially. All right, let's take a look at the final day, day number 10. And see how that fared too. After XQ came off the back of a second place, they kept that engine going with a first place here in the final day of the week. First place, second place, fourth place, sixth place, and eighth place across those games, respectively. And with a 15 kills coming in on that first place on Vikendi, another map that I believe that they're able to do very, very well in when it comes to the averages across the entirety of the PMPL Americas. It's great to see them doing so well. B4 is another team that we haven't really touched on too much, but this day started out with them getting back-to-back chicken dinners, and there was the potential of them getting even more throughout that day. Unfortunately for them, they fall in fifth place in the last game of the day with just 4 kills, but they were in a great spot on that Erangel to potentially get a triple, and that would have been stellar, but it just sticks with the 2 for now. Let's take a look at our 11th through 16th to round out the week as a whole. As you can see here, a few of the familiar faces, unfortunately, for these guys getting some of those lower placements. But it's unfortunately to be expected right now for these guys. The lobby is slowly sorting itself out, and we're seeing consistently the big names in those top spots. It was a bit of a rough day for Lazarus, kind of a bump on the head, and you know they'll shake that off and be able to rally back once again. So that's how every day shaped up individually. Now we can take a look back at the team that was able to do best here. So which team was able to perform best this week? And, well, after Kirillo was the MVP, not too much surprise that Loops Esports will be able to garner the best stats here from week number 2. Phenomenal stuff by them once again. And it really was shown and showcased in days number one, as well as day four of that week in particular. So day six, day nine, they were able to get those quad chicken dinners throughout those days, and that gave them a ton of points. But what's really special about loops is that even when they're not necessarily getting those chicken dinners, they're still getting a lot of kills off those second places, off of those third places, and they look like such a strong unit together. It's not just Kirillo, even though he's the MVP, they're all sticking with one another. You can really see the friend bond in a team like Loops Esports. All right, so let's take a look back at week number one and see how the points actually shaped up there, and then we can actually compare that to how things looked in week number two as well. So this is the end of week one. We see B4 getting themselves 245 points up towards the top and three chicken dinners. Now, their campaign in week one did not start off that great by any stretch of the imagination. They didn't have a good first day, but they really did ramp things up as the week went on. Wildcard is another team that kind of actually did even better, I would say, in terms of consistency than B4 to a certain degree, because their day number one was totally fine. Their first play day, even, I should say, was totally fine, and that afforded them kind of what is now the second place for that week number one. Likewise, Loops, zero chicken dinners after week one, but still consistent gods with 230 points. And of course, as I've just mentioned, you know, in week two, that they were able to start racking up those chicken dinners tremendously. Let's take a look at our 11 through 20 as well here, down towards the bottom. Again, reminder, this is just the first week of play. As you see, Alpha, Omen Elite, Cloud9, Ace1 there. Ace1, zero chicken dinners in this week. Unfortunately for them at this point, still no chicken dinners on the board, but you've got to expect with some of the second places that they've had on things like Vikendi, etc., it's gonna happen eventually here for the PMPL Americas. All right, so that is week one, how things stand. Grunto, actually, take note of that, in 20th place in week number one, because week number two really did see kind of a bit more of a resurgence for a team that was having a bit of a hard time communicating with one another on the battlefield, but we'll see how things change up. So let's compare that now to the standings from week two. Again, these are separate points from week one, so you can really start comparing the numbers as they flow in here. So Loops Esports managed in week two to gain themselves the four chicken dinners, as previously mentioned, and 264 points. B4 kind of only falls down that one rank in terms of how they were able to place throughout the week with 255 points. But here's an interesting thing. In week one, it was the same top six teams. And in week two, it is the same top six teams. However, the team that has fallen most in regards to that top six is Wildcard Gaming. So, do they have to be concerned about that consistency throughout week two, or did some of the other teams actually catch up to them in regards to their overall performances? Regardless, it's a name that we're going to be looking forward to seeing if they're able to acquire that World League placement. And I believe they will. I believe they will. Let's take a look at our 11th through 20th as well here to finish up week number two, as we have some moves, some shakes. Now, as I said at the end of week one, cast your mind back and think to yourself, how was Grunto Esports faring? In week one, they got 20th place. However, coming into week two, after a solid amount of time playing with one another and a few changes here and there, we started to see them get chicken dinners. They started to be more consistent, and they got themselves the 12th place at the end of week two. If they can continue that kind of progression, then who knows where a team like Grunto Esports could end up. And ladies and gentlemen, that is our recap here for week number two of the PMPL Americas. We shall see you next time for more PUBG Mobile action. But before we do, here's some of the greatest highlights here from week number two.
Will he manage to make it pay off? Levi, I think he's been spotted behind the tree. They swing out wide, and Levi there.
Oh my God.
Just dismantles the push from Loops. Finds one, finds two.
Ready to rock and roll. Knight's all the way out there on the outskirts. Here comes a push from Loops.
No, it's a third party. This was going to be Trem Coretta versus Team Queso, but instead, oh my goodness, Loops, they came for the third party and they found, and we're going to be finished off as well. So we're in the two versus three. It's Trem Coretta here up against the Knights. It's J7 now repeating down the hill, but this is so crazy. How this shot's not connecting? J7 is still alive, but the vehicle, Yeah, it's going to be blown up, and now Raven has to come down from the skies as Quinn goes down, as does his teammate. It seems Cap in just a few seconds as, yeah, up the stairs they come, and down to the grave, Ace go, as they are exiting out in 16th.